We have 159 election directors, thousands of poll workers, election workers, hundreds of volunteers on adjudication panels. They are all in there, as the secretary noted. This is a public process. You can watch everything that's happening. They work on top of paperwork in many cases. We know one of the things we know from the from Wednesday night on, we knew the basic amount of ballots that were there. With the slight moving target of the military coming in, the absentee ballots being cured, and the potential provisionals, because those are all essentially unknowable at the end of the night on Tuesday. People ask the question, well, why can't you know exactly how many you have? Because it's impossible, because there's the law allows for these things to be done to protect the ballots of those who we really want to make sure get to vote. So in general, and specifically, this office has worked very hard through the reforms in HB 316, which also allow for notifications to be immediately sent out for ballots that are received towards the end of the process that need to be cured. People talk about it's a three-day cure process on this, and that's not the case. If you sent in your ballot, you have a month-long cure process if it comes in that way. That's why I was always encouraging people to do that as early as they possibly could. But our office and the counties have many, many safeguards and many, many guardrails built up over many years to ensure the integrity of the vote.
Yes, sir.
Well, I'm not going to talk about an ongoing investigation at this time, but harvesting votes for a recount would be difficult because you already have the outward edge of what the recount already showed, or the original count already showed. Yes, sir. I'm not going to try to get into the president's actual mindset on that, because there are Republicans who are involved, there are Democrats involved at different levels. It's sort of a shared service delivery model. There are Republican election directors, there are Democrat election directors. Obviously, the Secretary Raffensperger is a Republican. Not that anybody who knows me, and I've suddenly had a lot of people look at my Twitter feed and my LinkedIn. It's pretty obvious. So, in general, we have people who have partisan beliefs. But the job of elections directors in this office is to count every legal vote, follow the law, and assure that every legal vote is counted and the will and intent of the voters is met.
Do you think that the curing process and the absentee from military, is that going to be enough to make a difference here?
We have no way of knowing. It possibly could. The one thing people have asked me with this 8,900 potential military ballots coming in, they asked me how many. I said, I don't know. I can tell you one thing. It'll be more than zero. It'll be less than 8,900. Yes. As I said, we can't know because they're in the post office. It's like I said, it'll be more than zero and less than 8,900. Yes, sir. Here's the situation. The risk-limiting audit has to be done before there is a recount anyway, so no, that shouldn't really have an effect on that. And to clear up one thing, I want to make sure everybody understands. The law in Georgia is that the candidates must be within 0.5% of each other in order to have a recount. So I'm hearing speculation potentially about a recount in the United States Senate race involving Mr. Ossoff and Senator Perdue. That margin is so wide with the amount of available ballots out right now, there's no way the two of them could probably get to the 0.5 each. I mean, potentially they could, but it's very unlikely. So it would probably only be for president.
What is the physical recount? What would that look like? Is that scanning all the ballots through the machines again?
You're going to let me get into my fun geek time now to go over the SEB rules that we outlined when we passed this law. As I mentioned to y'all yesterday, the secretary directed that we procure in the original procurement the high-speed ICCs, which are the high-capacity, high-speed scanners that will be used at the central offices for this recount. Now, how we're going to do that is we're going to take a deck of ballots. We're going to have this hand-counted going by what is written on the human-readable portion of that, or the readable portion of that. We'll tally those, and we'll get a count, write it down. We will then run those through the scanners, and they ought to match. And once we validate that that scanner is scanning properly, we will then be scanning every single ballot again on the central scanners. Like I said, we're making estimates of time. We don't know. Like I said, I'm hoping there's some time when our elections workers will get some sleep. because, you know, it's going to be a high-stress thing because, again, the eyes of the world are upon them. But that's the essential outline of how it works. There's other details of how you handle it, but that's the basics.
I've heard from some voters about an issue where they showed up on Tuesday and they were told they had already been voted. Are you aware of that issue and what might have caused it?
We are aware that there's a couple potentially happening. We don't know exactly why yet. It could be a simple thing as on the poll pad it searches first name, last name, and date of birth. So they could have been looking at the wrong person, not realizing it immediately, because like I said, the poll workers are human, and human beings are involved at all this level, so there can be errors in those, but we are obviously looking into it with the vendor to see if there's anything that can be discovered about why that might have happened. Anybody else? Yes, sir. You again? I do not right now. We're trying to get that, but again, we're trying to leave the elections officials and directors to their actual counts. Yes, sir.
Real quick, I know you mentioned about 4,000 that are left pending in your provisional military. Mm-hmm. Realistically, from where we were yesterday and today, this could be done by midnight. Can you give us some level of timeline of when we could see that for everyone at home fighting their fingernails?
Well, here's the reality. I think the ballot talking about here today will probably be done today to tonight. But remember, close of business means there's stuff's coming in at close of business. So we don't know the volume of those. We don't know where they're going to be. Somebody could have left, you know, they could be exhausted and have to get the mail, you know, after that. So there's no way of knowing exactly. I anticipate we should get closer to final on Saturday. People going through with their damaged ballots, make sure they get copied, reconciled properly and copied and duplicated properly and scanned. So it'll be probably this weekend. If the difference wasn't 1,000 votes. Yes, sir. No, so no conversation.
You mentioned the closeness. Is that we're hearing a lot about the counting of ballots in Georgia and the speed we're counting them. Is this a counting problem, or is this simply a matter of the margin, the fact that we have so many, so close to the election?
There's two things in here. I know many people seem to forget we were still in the middle of a pandemic during a lot of this, so Georgia historically has about 5% absentee. So they've never had to handle this volume of paper before, and they're having to handle the volume of paper and the handling and all of the ballot custody rules around those things. There's extra things we never had to deal with before. I think we're going to make t-shirts that says I survived the 2020 election, where we have a pandemic, merging elections, hurricane, and then recounts. So that's going to be our plan, but it's mainly a question of the volume.
Yes, sir. Hey. Thanks for doing this.
Again, we can't know what's happening in all 159 counties. The only state with more counties than us is Texas. So we anticipate most of it will be, and the problem is they could find a couple things. We're doing the reconciliations. That's why you have certification, to get to that final number. And we're trying to get the counties to certify as fast as they can so we can move to our risk limiting audit, so then we can certify as fast as we can and move to what looks like a likely recount called by either one of the second place candidates. There was one in Chatham County. They wanted to have one more adjudication server, and that was supplied. Yes. About 17,000. About 17,000 have already, and those 17,000 are already included in the counts we have. Yes, sir. I'll come back in a second. You just want to see me get that computer back out again.
Yeah.
All right. Give me a second.
And to be clear, these are absentee ballots that remain to be counted. We do not have numbers on the official ballot.
Correct, except for there are 400 election day ballots that are included in the Gwinnett totals. So that's the only other difference in that. So, all right, so we'll start from the top. Cherokee, 150. Cobb, 75. Floyd, 444. Gwinnett, approximately 3,500. And for a total of 4,169.
Absentee,
except for the 400 of the ones in Gwinnett that were a part of the early voting that they had to rescan.
Okay.
All right. Anybody got anything else?
I got one more question.
All right. There.
Sorry. Can you talk about whether or not an investigation has been opened by your office into this question of water leak and state funding? Is there an investigation of that going on right now?
Not that I'm aware of. I mean, and let me I'm going to put some clarity to this because we have some more information about it. It wasn't a water main break. What it was during the off season and during the pandemic, they shut off the toilets and they were turned off, and there was a leak that got around one of the edges of the shutoff valves. And over time, and it's just kind of like we said, we got hit with a hurricane. I mean, I'm going to add a water leak to the t-shirt, I think, on the surviving election 2020. All right, anything else? Yeah.
Since you guys are investigating anything that has critical bearing, mm-hmm. are we talking about dozens, hundreds, how many investigations?
I really couldn't say right now, whatever we, because there's different levels of investigations. You do the phone calls to make sure there's any credibility. Then you're like, yes, there's credibility. Then there's a real investigation. So I'm not going to parse through that. Obviously, we're getting stuff. And, you know, if you look on Facebook and Twitter, obviously, there's millions of problems all across the country. If somebody has a credible complaint and they have some kind of evidence or some kind of trail to an evidence, they can give our office a call. And if they're in another state, give your state office a call, because we want to make sure we protect the integrity of the ballot, because that's the way you're going to build faith back in the system that the outcome of the election is correct. Thanks a lot, y'all.